गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। गुड
गुड मॉर्निंग
मॉर्निंग सर।
सर,
ओके, आई विल स्टार्ट विथ द इंट्रोडक्शन, इंट्रोड्यूस माई सेल्फ। ओके, माई नेम इज वीरेश, बेसिकली फ्रॉम माई इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स डिपार्टमेंट, एंड आई एम गोइंग टू हैंडल analog and digital electronics subject. That is the core of this subject is 18 CS 33. Okay, for you people. Okay, so before subject, let us have discussion on the previous semester. Okay, so what you have learned about this electronic subjects. Are you people hearing me?
No, sir.
Sir, your voice is.
Am I audible?
Your voice is not breakable.
It's too striking, sir.
Hello, am I audible to you all?
Yes, sir. Now you're audible.
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So I will continue. Okay. So if you get any doubts in between, you can just raise me. And if I ask any question, you people can reply me without any hesitation. I hope. Okay. Don't fear to reply and don't hesitate. You can freely talk with me. You can freely discuss with the class. And whatever the things I am going to ask you, you can clear them. Okay? Okay, fine. So, in the first year, all of you have gone through basic electronics, right?
Yes, sir.
So, I will just ask simple questions from that subject. Okay? Can anyone tell me what was the first unit, first module of the basic electronics? What was the first module of basic electronics subject in the first year?
Semiconductor diodes and their circuits.
Yes, semiconductor diodes and their circuits. So you know about the semiconductor, right? That is a PN junction.
Yes, sir.
Diode.
Yes, sir.
Okay, that is very good. And what was the second module?
Sir, bipolar junction something.
BJT transistor.
Yes, sir, BJT.
Bipolar junction transistor. So biasing is there. Have you learned about biasing in the BJT?
Yes, sir.
Yes, fixed biasing, collector based biasing, CB mode, CC mode, correct?
Sir, we learned about the forward and the backward biasing.
Okay, forward biasing and the reverse biasing. The characteristics of the BJT.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then what about the third module?
Sir, it was about operational amplifiers.
Yes, definitely. Operational amplifiers. And the characteristics, the applications of operational amplifiers, correct?
Yes.
Like a 555 timer. Have you gone through this? 555 timer or skimmit trigger, oscillator. Yes, okay, okay. Then what about the fourth module?
Field effect transistor.
Field effect transistor. FET. MOS FET. Yes? MOS. Metal oxide semiconductor. FET.
MOSFET.
MOSFET. NMOS, PMOS, and the function and the working of MOS FET. Okay. And at the last, what was the fifth module?
Digital Electronics Fundamentals.
Yes, Digital Electronics Fundamentals. What you learnt in that? Or what
number
you have?
Number system.
Sorry?
Number system.
Mm-hmm.
Basic and universal gates, full adder, half adder, multiplexer.
Oh, then that is very good. Okay, flip so number and you have gone through number systems, right?
Yes, sir.
What is the number system that we use in our daily life, in our life?
Zero and one.
Huh? What is the number system that we use in our daily life? Sorry, you don't know?
No, sir.
How many number systems are there? Means which are the number systems you have gone through in the fifth module?
Sir, binary number system, decimal, yeah. Hexadecimal, octal.
Okay. So out of these four, which one we are going to use in our daily life?
Sir, decimal number system, I guess.
Decimal number system, correct? So how many numbers are there in the decimal number system?
0 to 10.
There is total 10.
10 numbers.
0 to 9.
0 to 9, sir.
Yes, total 10 numbers.
Yes.
Okay, in binary?
0.
How many numbers are there in binary?
Sir, 2 numbers, sir.
Which are those?
0 and 1.
Okay.
0 and 1.
So what is 1? What is 1 plus 1 in binary?
Incremental of it.
What is the result of 1 plus 1 in binary system?
1 now.
1?
0.
0?
One zero, sir.
Yes, 1 0. I hope everyone has gone through this number system, addition, binary. Most important is binary number system, right? When we enter into a digital electronics, then a binary system and hexadecimal system matters a lot. Okay. So 1 plus 1 is going to be 1 0. Okay. How it comes? Okay, that we will see some other time. We will have just a simple introduction today. Okay, so this in the third semester, now you are going to learn about analog and digital electronics. Whereas in the previous semester, four modules were related to basic, that is analog electronics. And one module, the fifth module, was related to digital electronics. Okay, in the first year subject. And now, one in this subject, one module is related to analog electronics and four modules are related to digital electronics. Okay. So, what is the difference between the analog electronics and digital electronics? Can anyone tell me?
Sir, in analog electronics, there is a continuously varying signals.
Yes. So, analog electronics is a study of analog signal. Correct?
Yes, sir.
In electrical pulses, sir. Varying in electrical pulses.
Where?
In analog.
In analog. So overall, I will simply tell in a one sentence, analog electronics is a study of analog signals and the devices which are generating the analog signals. Correct?
Yes.
Do you agree with this?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So what about the digital electronics? You can tell the same way.
Study of digital signals and the devices using such signals.
Yes, not using such signals. The devices which are going to generate that digital signal. So we are going to learn about those devices. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay. With the one more question, the last question, I want to ask you peoples that what is the purpose of this binary number system? What was the purpose? Why they have published this binary number system?
Sir, because the computer used the binary number system.
No, before there was no computers, no? Because of computers, the binary system was not built. Because of binary system, the computer was built. Before computers only, the binary system was there. Actually, the binary system was established published in around 1700 century. So what was the purpose? Shall I tell you?
For use of true or false, open, close, or yes or no.
Yes, what is that called, yes or no? Open or close?
Conditions, sir.
Conditions. It is a logic.
Logic conditions. Yes, sir.
Correct?
Yes, sir.
So, the purpose of digital or the binary number is to join the logic with the mathematics. The logic operations are joined with the mathematics. So, that was the purpose. The arithmetic expressions was very complex. To make it easier, it has been converted or it has been joined with the logics. Yes or no? Only in two conditions. Only in two logics. So that was the fundamental of this binary number system. So the person who published this binary number system was a George Boole. George Boole. I think you have heard about a Boolean algebra.
Yes, sir.
So that was, he was a person, he was a scientist who has published this binary number system. Okay, so he has some set of rules. What are those rules? What are those logics? He has published some of the logics, correct? Boolean.
Yes, sir.
What are those set of rules?
Identity rule.
Identity rule. What are those?
Complement.
Logic function. Do you know AND logic, OR logic?
Yes, sir.
XOR logic. Yes?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, such kind of logic rules he has published. Okay, so whereas addition of 1 plus 1 is 1, 0, but the Boolean algebra for OR gate, 1 plus 1 is 1 only. OR logic. OR logic is different, addition is different. I hope you have gone through all the logic gates, basic logic gates.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so Okay, I think that is very good that I heard many of the things from your class. So most of the basics regarding this binary number system, I hope everyone knows about it. Okay, I will not discuss about this binary number system, hexadecimal number system. Maybe all of you know about converting the hexadecimal number into the binary number system, right? Because in basic electronics only, you have all come through this conversion of number systems. And also you have come across combinational logic circuits and all those. Okay. So this is what I feel it's the good regarding this. And then here we will see what are the topics that we are going to study or we are going to understand in this semester. Okay. So here is a syllabus copy. Can anyone see? I think everyone can see this.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Okay.
So module one. So what is it regarding this module one? It is regarding analog electronics. Because we are going to learn, we are going to understand about the photodiode functionality, light emitting diode, LED functionality, optocouplers, BJT biasing, operational amplifiers, then filters and conversion of and digital to analog and analog to digital. So this is regarding the analog electronics. Okay, so the first module, only the first module, is related to analog electronics. So where we are to learn about analog. Okay, then the module two. So the module 2 is basically for simplifying the digital expressions. So hopefully you know about min term expressions, max term expressions, right? Have you gone through that?
No, sir.
No,
variable expressions. Boolean algebra? No? Okay. So in the module 2, we will be having some of the methods like a Karnaugh map and Quinn-McCluskey method to solve these expressions, digital expressions. Okay. And then in module 3, we are again going to learn about the combinational circuit designs, combinational circuits and simulation of the gates by using these combinational circuits. Okay, so fan in, fan out, and gate delays and timing diagrams, hazards and multiplexers. As you have already gone through this, multiplexers, decoders and programmable logic devices, PLDs, PAL. So many topics are there. As we go on, we will study, we will learn everything. So here, these are all the 1 to 5 modules. Now, in the second page, can you see? Hello? Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, okay. Sir.
So the second page is showing about course outcomes. Course is nothing but one subject. Okay. course is nothing but one subject. Program is nothing but one department. Okay, in the general statement we say it as a department, like a computer science department, electronics and communication department. So instead of that, we call them as a program, computer science program, electronics program. So in this program, this is one of the course, analog and digital electronics. So in this course, there are four outcomes. When we complete this course, we will be knowing, or the student will be able to understand the four main points. So this is like a summary of the course. Okay. So what are the things that student is going to able? The first outcome is, see, I have written 203.1, correct?
Yes,
203. So that is point number one. Can anyone read?
Yes, sir.
Read it.
Analyze application of analog circuits using photo devices, timer IC, power supply, regulator IC, op-amp, and ADC-DAC.
Yes. So these are all the topics that the student is going to analyze. The student is able to analyze the photo devices, timer IC, power supply, regulator IC, op-amp, and ADC-DAC. Okay. Do you know, have you come to know what is course outcome? It is the output of the first module. Yes?
Yes, sir.
Okay. What is the second output of the module? The second output of this course? Yes. Read it, please.
Simplifying digital circuits using Karnaugh map and Quinn-Mikulski methods.
Yes, Quinn-Mikulski. It is quite hard to pronounce it. So these are two different methods that we are going to simplify the expressions. Okay. Digital circuit expressions. Then the outcome three is what?
Explain logic gates and make use in combinational circuits and contrast and logic devices such as PLAs and PALs.
Okay. So this is what regarding the third module. And fourth module, fifth module, both are included and both are giving the fourth outcome. What is the fourth outcome?
Develop simple HDL models for combinational circuits and explain flip-flops and make us in designing different data processing circuits and registers and counters.
Yes, actually it is a make use in designing different data processing circuits. So flip-flops are explained in this. Flip-flops are used in a different data processing circuits and registers and counters. Along with that, we are going to develop a simple HDL models. We will see what will be the HDL long form and whatever the functions of HDL in the fifth module, fourth module as well as fifth module. So by covering all five modules, we will be able to know these four outcomes. Okay. And below that, there is one more table that I will explain when you once enter into the department. Okay. This is general thing that you should know. What is a mapping of course outcome with a program outcome? What is a mapping of course outcomes? What are the course outcomes? So I feel today it is enough that we have discussed about the previous subject related to this subject and the syllabus copy and the output of this course or of this syllabus. Okay. So we will continue in the next class. Thank you, one and all.
Thank you, sir.
Excuse me, listen to me. How about my language? Is it clear to you?
Yes, sir. It's clear.
Sir.
Okay. So, is there any doubts that or in speech, what I am speaking to you, what we are discussing, is there understanding?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then that is good. In coming classes, we will discuss more than this. And once you enter into a department, we will interact physically, right? Okay. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.